Hi everyone, in this part of the video let's discuss about Wegener's continental drift theory. It was the first theory with respect to continental drift, or explaining the present position of continents and previous position of the continents. So let's start. Okay, what did the Wegener say? According to Wegener, all the continents were united into single landmass, okay, as shown in this picture. Okay, all the continents were united into single large landmass, where this landmass, large landmass, was called Pangaea, which was surrounded by the large ocean, okay, which was called Panthalassa. This was the statement given by this theory, that is, all the continents were united into single large landmass called Pangaea, and it was surrounded by ocean called as Panthalassa. Over a period of time, these continents broke, as shown in the line here, which continents broke from the Pangaea and drifted apart to its present position, where the present position is given here, okay, where all these were united into a single large landmass. Okay, now let's discuss the evidence which is quoted by Wegener. What are the evidences? Okay, according to Wegener, the evidence quoted by him is similarity of landmass. Wegener stated that these continents, such as these, the coast of South America matches with the coast of Africa. Similarity of the coastal lines of Africa and South America and USA, North America and Europe. Okay, this was the first evidence. The second evidences was when rock samples were collected from the various continents, and its radiometric using radiometric method, when the age of these rocks were found, it was found that these rocks were all of same age. This was second evidence. The third evidence is tillets. What is tillets? Tillets is nothing but sedimentary rock. It's sedimentary rocks formed by the glacial deposits of sediments. Suppose if a glacier flows, okay, the underground mud will be trapped. Okay, these trap, the rocks which will be trapped below the glaciers, will get broken into sediments. These sediments get accumulated, compacted, consolidates, and forms tillets, that is sedimentary rocks. Okay, when tillets were recorded of various, continents, it was found that the tillets which were originated from Indian Peninsula had its counterparts in six other landmasses. Okay, what are landmasses? That is Madagascar, Africa, Antarctica, Australia, Falkland Islands. These were the six landmasses. This was the third evidence. What are the fourth evidence? Fourth evidence was with respect to the placer deposits of gold. Okay, it is found that the gold deposits which are found in Ghana, let me show you, the Ghana is located in this part. Okay, here the gold is found, but it didn't have any source origin. There was no source, but later on it was found that this source of gold deposit is from Brazilian plateau. There is gold mines in the Brazil. Okay, it is from Brazilian plateau. So placer deposit was the fourth evidence. Okay, now fossil fields. When the various marine plants and animals, when the plants and animals of different continents were same, okay, when the, such as the Mesosaurus of South Africa and Africa, as you all can see, when you find that the animals are different, animals of different continents are present in different continents, it is found that these continents were united at one time. Such as other animals is lemurs of India. The lemurs which is present in India is also present in Madagascar. So it proves that these two landmass were united at a period of time. Similarly, Mesosaurus, which is present in Brazil, is also present in South Africa. So these two landmasses were united over a period of time, like in the history. Okay, what are the next evidence? The next evidence is with respect to Appalachian Mountains. The Appalachian Mountains comes here. Okay, it matches, it has its counterpart in northwestern Europe. Okay, This continuation, like this part, the part of continuation of this mountain is present in northwestern Europe. Okay, this was the last evidence. Now let's discuss what Wegener tried to explain, okay, using his theory. According to Wegener, the forces which are responsible for continental drifting, since there should be some force so that the continents which are united again once breaks and moves in their own direction, which is the result of which is the present day continents. So the force for breaking of this continent is differential gravitational force. Okay, usually the continents, the Pangaea was like this, single last landmarks, it broke into two part. The southern part is called as Gondwana, the northern part is called Laurasia or Angara. Laurasia. This breaking of north and south was due to differential gravitational force, and the movement of these parts in the western direction, such as North America moved towards west, South America moved towards west, is due to tidal force. This was explained by the Wegener, the forces which are responsible for continental drift. The next is mountain building. What is mountain building? Like, according to Wegener, mountains were formed when the, such as South American part drifted towards west, the ocean was surrounded by them, right? This ocean floor offered resistance to the South American block. When the resistance was offered, this part got folded and there led to a rise of Andes mountains. Similarly, with respect to North America, when North America was offered resistance by the seafloor, Rocky Mountains were formed. Okay, this was with respect to mountain building. Now, origin of islands. As we all know that the Asia is the largest continent, the island arc was formed when this Asia, that is Eurasian landmass or Europe plus Asian plate, was moving in the westward direction. This eastern part could not keep pace with this old landmass, and hence small parts got separated, and hence these formed island arcs. Okay. Now, fourth, what is Wegener tried to explain? The fourth part he tried to explain is Carboniferous glaciation. As we all know, the Pangaea was like this, like all the landmasses were united into a single block called Pangaea. Durban was located here. This Durban acted as South Pole. When this South Pole was acted, all the continents were surrounding, right? So when this acted as South Pole, the surrounding landmass were glaciated. As we know that South Pole will have higher art, like lower temperature, and hence this resulted in glaciation, and hence that explained Carboniferous glaciation. Though Wegener theory successfully explained certain things, but there was very major drawback with respect to Wegener theory. What were the major drawbacks? The drawbacks were that, as you all know, the Pangaea, according to Wegener, the tidal force and the gravitational force divided this Pangaea into two, northern block and southern block. And these blocks, the North American block moved towards west, South American block moves towards west through tidal force. Okay, according to Wegener, tidal force and gravitational force acted, but in reality, these two forces are not sufficient. Okay, this was the first drawback. The second drawback is, Wegener, according to Wegener, continental drift theory is that these, the Sima blocks, sialic blocks, that is, the continental landmass floats over the sea floors. Okay, this was stated by him, but according to mountain building theory, he stated that it was formed due to resistance offered by sea floor. Hence, there was a contradictory statement by Wegener, and Wegener failed to explain pre-Carboniferous glaciation. This was the drawback. So I have covered what is continental drift theory by Wegener, plus evidences and the things he had explained with respect to mountain building, continental drift, Iceland as, and Carboniferous glaciation and drawbacks. So I have covered all the topics with respect to continental drift theory. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe. If you have any doubt, please let me know in the comment section. I will be covering each and every topic. Please hit the bell icon so you can guess it. Okay, I'll be covering polity, geography, economics and other subjects also. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.